lies will be exposed. That's all. And one who takes that the wrong way know why they take it the wrong way.
Investigation is underway at Drake's home. Chopper tour above the scene this morning. It shows the street shut down just outside of 21 Park Lane Circle.
You lied about your daughter, huh? You lied about them other kids that's out there hoping that you come. Yeah, baby.
Earlier this year, Katt Williams made a prediction on Club Xiexie that the powerful and rich in Hollywood will soon face karma and have everything about their questionable behavior exposed. Katt Williams was apparently uncannily accurate when she predicted this outcome. Recent events suggest that Drake could be living in complete terror due to allegations made against him by fellow rapper Kendrick Lamar. So what exactly was said by Kendrick Lamar? To put things in perspective, the biggest rap feud in years has grown more intense and personal between Drake and Kendrick Lamar, who have been leveling unfounded charges at one another. Lamar's claim that Drake has a hidden love child and Drake's charge that Lamar physically mistreated his partner were two of them. Lamar has been emphasizing assertions in his latest songs that Drake is a P. He accuses Drake directly of encouraging S-offenders at his label OVO in the May 3rd release, Meet the Grams, even calling his rival a P for his alleged interest in younger women. In addition, he advises we should raise our girls with the understanding that there are other P's out there who are just like him. In Meet the Grams, Kendrick Lamar also raps on how the embassies would eventually be overrun as well. A direct reference to Drake's property, which he has dubbed the embassy, and a link to recent government searches on scene Diddy Palm's homes over an unspecified ongoing investigation. Lamar restated the accusations he had made against Like Us in a statement on May 4. Lamar more directly alludes to Drake as a predator in the song Drake, I Hear You Like Him Young in the lyrics. Kendrick Lamar makes allusion to Drake's 2021 album when he says, Certified Lover Boy, Certified Peas, referring to Drake and his group. A phrase that seems like it's trying to hit a minor chord comes after this. Lamar accuses Moore with the cover art for the Not Like Us song, which has a Google Maps image of Drake's home covered with P-Map pins. Drake reacts to all of Kendrick Lamar's accusations in a song that was posted on YouTube on Sunday. Titled The Heart Part 6, it is a parody of Kendrick Lamar's well-received 2022 single, The Heart Part 5. Aretha Franklin sings the opening line of the song, Now Let Me See You Prove It, Just Let Me See You Prove It. A snippet from Franklin's song, Prove It, is included. Drake raps in The Heart Part 6, taking on the essay, claims head-on. Let's speak about anything concerning a child at this time. This Epstein approach kind of made sense to me. TikTok videos that you collected and looked over. Instead of being on some misdirect-ish, you rather fing grab your pen and misdirect-ish, accusing Lamar of disseminating false information. Later in the song, Drake disputes the charges once more. No teenager would get two looks from me. The rapper casually brought up his supposed inappropriate connection with Millie Bobby Brown, star of Stranger Things. During an interview with Access Hollywood in 2018, Millie said that she and Drake had become friends by messaging each other when Millie was just 14 years old. Regardless, Drake suggests in the song that Lamar is accusing him of being a predator so the Compton rapper can process and portray his own grief of allegedly being abused as a child. Hold on, this is the song where you say you got S-A'd, aw, screw me, I just saw the connection, this is going to become pretty dark, Drake murmurs. Because of your own confessions, you are traumatized. This is what occurs when your father abandons you unattended at home. Such indifference. That's why I'm so infatuated with these P-raps. It certainly is excessive. In The Heart Part 6, Outbro, Drake raps, you'd be a worthy competitor if I was really a pre. You weren't effing lying to every editor and blogger, even though that is the reality. Although many fans first disregarded these serious charges made by Lamar, Drake's rebuttal has made them consider whether the rapper's allegations could have any merit. Anyway, these aren't the only claims that Kendrick Lamar has made. Kendrick Lamar seems to be hinting at a connection between Drake's poverty and that of a Toronto man in his other song, Euphoria. Kendrick told the audience he had insider information on Drake that might get him arrested as he performed the lyrics. We don't have to be intimate. Regardless, later on in the song, Kendrick rapped, I'm at New Ho King eating fried rice with a dip sauce and blamey Crody. Tell me you're cheesy, family. Croyd, let's do this on camera now. New Ho King is a Chinese restaurant on Spadina Avenue in Toronto. Rapper Sizzlak of Toronto recently recorded a music video at New Ho King. Sizzlak is also thought to be among those that robbed Drake in 2009 while holding a pistol to his head. When Sizzlak's diss song, Realist in the City, was released in Toronto, it caused a commotion. It was aimed at Drake. Shortly after the video was released to the public, Sislak was shot and died. Rumor has it that goon who had spotted Sislak at the same restaurant followed him and shot him, albeit the case is still open. Either way, it seems like Kendrick Lamar was right about Drake. The Canadian rapper's security guard was shot outside his home during the night, according to current Toronto police reports. Tuesday at around 2 in the morning, suspects in a vehicle shot the guard at the corner of the Park Lane Circle home before driving off, according to the police. Whether Drake was at home when the incident occurred, or if he was the intended target, is still uncertain. The Integrated Gun and Gang Task Force's Inspector Paul Krosek informed reporters on Tuesday morning, "We are in contact with his team and they are cooperating. It would be premature," he continued, "to suggest a motivation at this stage of the investigation." He claims that the police are now reviewing video that captures the event, but they are concealing specifics due to issues with the tape's quality. According to police, the patient is receiving treatment at a hospital and is in severe condition. On Tuesday morning, an RV trailer and a black limousine were parked outside the house, and witnesses told Canadian media that he was suffering from several gunshot wounds. It appears that detectives are coming and going from the rapper's estate. There are still a few clear signs of the shooting scattered around the road, such as little orange cones and evidence markers that the police have removed. Police tape encircles Drake's home's front yard, appearing to even stretch over the courtyard. In any case, Diddy's experience from over a month ago sounds a lot like this. In case you missed it, federal agents from Homeland Security Investigations executed search warrants at Scene Diddy Combs' homes in Miami and Los Angeles on March 25. The HSI conducted law enforcement activities while conducting an ongoing investigation, with assistance from HSI Miami, HSI Los Angeles, and its regional law enforcement partners. Information of the investigation became public when Combs refuted claims of sexual misconduct in lawsuits filed by many victims starting in November. He stated in a December Instagram statement, "Sickening allegations have been made against me by individuals looking for a quick payday. Let me be very clear. I didn't do any of the terrible things that people were accusing me of. I'm going to fight for my family, my name, and the truth." According to informed sources, during a federal authorities raid on March 25, firearms were found at the rapper's multi-million dollar estates in Miami and Los Angeles. Moreover, Combs' phones were seized by Homeland Security agents in Miami before he was scheduled to go for a Bahamas vacation. According to a person close to the investigation, the raid was connected to allegations of illegal persons trafficking, SA, solicitation, and distribution of illegal weapons and narcotics. The investigation is currently ongoing. He alleges that in exchange for his work on the Love album, which was published on September 15, 2023, he was cheated of over $50,000, tortured to chemical and psychological abuse, and humiliated in rituals. In Jones' arresting 70-page complaint, Combs, 54, is accused of trying to get Jones to accept gay partnerships, which are prevalent in the music industry. Tyron Blackburn, an attorney, is representing Jones in his allegations that a RKKL organization has been active for a while but has never taken the required action to monitor or alert Scene Combs. This story involves some of the most influential figures in the music industry. Sir Lucian Grange, CEO of Universal Music Group, Ethiopia Haftamariam, former CEO of Motown, and Diddy's 30-year-old son Justin are among the other accused, along with his senior assistant Christina Coram. According to the intricately photo-illustrated lawsuit, Mr. Jones saw, experienced, and witnessed a great deal during his time working with Mr. Combs that went well beyond his responsibilities as the producer of the Love album. According to the petition, Mr. Jones possesses hundreds of hours worth of audio and video footage purportedly capturing Mr. Combs, his staff, and his guests participating in gravely illegal behavior. It further mentions that Mr. Combs requested that Mr. Jones continuously record him. The complaint alleges that throughout the year and a half that Jones traveled the country collaborating with Combs on the multi-producer Love album, he met a few of the well-known associates of his de facto employer, and things didn't always work out. According to Jones, the Oscar winner caressed, stroked, and touched Mr. Jones's legs, his upper inner thighs near his crotch, and the small of his back near his shoulders, during one visit with Cuba Gooding Jr., who has been accused of wrongdoing of his own. Jones said that Young Miami, the female cousin of Diddy's fiancée, had also allegedly essayed him. Given the manner that Diddy's case has been worsening, many are confident that Drake will be accused of similar crimes. As someone once said, we have witnessed the beginning of Drake's downfall in the past week. In the last week, we have witnessed the beginning of Drake's downfall.